In our last Friday's video, we presented the top 10 reasons which speak for colonizing the Moon before Mars. And now we of course want to be fair, so we will tell you the top 10 reasons why it could actually make more sense to first colonize Mars.
So then let's get started right away. So before we are going to talk next time about our preferred scenario, namely colonizing the Moon and Mars at the same time, we now first want to look at all the pros Mars offers as compared to the Moon. In what areas is Mars ahead of the Moon regarding its potential for human habitation? Well, first of all, when we look at Mars, we note that
1. The length of a Martian day is almost exactly that of Earth, while the Moon is tidally locked to Earth and rotates only once every 28 days. In a weird twist of fate, Mars comes along with a rotation period of 24 hours and 37 minutes, only slightly longer than an Earth rotation. Therefore, our sleeping patterns, for example, wouldn't suffer so much on Mars, as people could probably adapt very fast to those extra 37 minutes. This is of course very beneficial for our biological processes, which are used to the regular day-night cycle here on Earth. But to make it even funnier,
2. The axial tilt of Mars is almost the same that of Earth. The Earth has an axial tilt of 23.5 degrees, which, as we know, gives rise to seasons. Without this tilt, we wouldn't have the changing seasons that we are used to. Except in Germany, where it's always autumn, even when it's supposed to be summer. Damn you, German weather, damn you! Sorry for that outburst. So where were we? Mars. Mars's axial tilt is, incredibly, only slightly over 25 degrees. So therefore, we would experience very similar seasonal patterns like here on Earth, making the whole experience on Mars even more Earth-like. And because compared to the Moon, Mars has an atmosphere.
3. The temperature swings on Mars are not as wild as on the Moon. Martian summers are a lot warmer than winters, with temperatures up to plus 30 degrees Celsius during the winter night at the poles. However, it can drop as low as minus 195 degrees Celsius. But still, because of the presence of an atmosphere, this is still much better than on the Moon, where the temperature fluctuations range from plus 100 degrees Celsius in the sun to even below minus 200 degrees Celsius in the long lunar night. And during a Martian night in summer, temperatures actually wouldn't drop below minus 80 degrees Celsius. Therefore, we would experience temperature fluctuations of around 110 degrees Celsius between a Martian day and night, as compared to up to 300 degrees Celsius of fluctuations on the Moon. So the temperatures on Mars are more beneficial for all equipment, so that it wouldn't experience such high strain due to thermal expansion and contraction. Plus, we'd also have a very...
4. Earth-like topography. While the Moon is really a very dead and alien landscape with its pitch-black sky and completely cratered surface, Mars actually looks surprisingly Earth-like in many places. We find dry riverbeds all over the place, we find sand dunes, hills, layered structures of sediment rocks, we find canyons and buttes not unlike as found in some American national parks. And because of the atmosphere, the sky on Mars would not appear black as on the Moon, thus Mars would offer a quite familiar, not too alien landscape. Now, okay, the sky has a reddish color due to the iron oxide-rich sand, which preferably scatters longer wavelengths towards the red end of the visible spectrum, while on Earth the air molecules scatter preferably blue light, giving rise to the blue sky we know on Earth. But still, the overall feeling would be like in some parts of Arizona, with the sky red instead of blue. Except during sunset and sunrise, when the sky is actually blue, due to the red wavelengths being scattered out because the light travels a longer path through the atmosphere during sunrise and sunset. which gives the Martian settlers, be it only for a short time during Mars morning and Mars evening, the feeling of seeing that beautiful, old, familiar blue sky again.
5. The gravity on Mars is a lot higher than on the Moon. Mars sports a gravity of 37.94% of Earth gravity. This might seem pretty low as compared to Earth, but compare it to the Moon with its 16.54% Earth gravity, suddenly you realize that you weigh 2.29 times more on Mars than on the Moon. So spending a lot of time on the Moon would make your muscles and bones disintegrate much faster than on Mars. While there haven't been any studies conducted in low non-zero-g environment, it's logical to assume that long stays on Mars are a lot healthier for the human body than on the Moon. We don't know for sure yet how detrimental the 37.94% Mars gravity would be for the human body. But if we are lucky, it might be enough to just increase our bone and muscle mass with genetic engineering. Whereas on the Moon, it's highly likely that we would need some kind of centrifugal rotational habitat for long duration stays. And for long duration stays, we are of course very happy to find out that on Mars, there's a lot of
6. Water ice below ground. We find that Mars actually has quite large water ice reserves in form of permafrost ice below the ground, with the quantity increasing towards the poles. So the further towards the north or south pole we go, the higher the water ice reserves, as can be seen on this map here. That's one of the reasons why the Erebus Monte site on Mars is one of the preferred sites for our first Mars base. There are huge water ice reserves below the ground there, then it's still not too far away from the equator, so that the solar flux is still high enough to allow for efficient use of solar panels, and at the same time, Erebus Montes is really low-lying, therefore the atmospheric pressure is higher, thus offering a better protection against cosmic rays.
7. Mars is a more interesting target in the search for life. While the Moon is a sterile, completely dead world, Mars is, as we said, not only surprisingly Earth-like in many regards, but is also a very good candidate where we could discover alien life. The likelihood that Mars bacteria exist is actually not so low. With the former lead scientist of the Viking labored release experiment, Gilbert Levine, still maintaining his position to this day that the Viking probes discovered Martian microorganisms back in 1976. Even more so, you know there are large underground lava tubes and cave systems on Mars that go who knows how deep into the planet's crust, potentially so deep as to offer life-friendly warmer temperatures. And there you would of course have complete protection against any form of solar or cosmic radiation. And since we know that Mars was actually a very life-friendly planet in the past, with a giant ocean probably covering the entire northern hemisphere, and with a much thicker atmosphere than today, even allowing for clouds of water vapor or rain, and all that for at least 1, probably even 2 billion years. Thus, the likelihood that some form of Martian life developed back then is quite high.
Now the question, of course, is, did that life survive and find new living space in the deep caves and lava tubes of Mars when the atmosphere started thinning out and thus Mars got colder and drier? Well, only human missions can find this out and what form of life it is. Would it be only microorganisms or maybe even some simple fungi or sponges? 8. Much more interesting landscape formations. Now, while the Moon has some quite spectacular surface features, Mars completely destroys the poor Moon in this regard. We have the highest volcano in the entire solar system, Olympus Mons, with an incredible height of around 25 kilometers and a diameter of around 600 kilometers. But more, we have the gigantic canyon system Valles Marineris, which is a relaxed 6,000 kilometers long from side to side and up to 9 kilometers deep. You know, totally normal stuff. I mean, this even puts the Grand Canyon to shame. And we have ancient riverbeds, we have fascinating layered poles made out of carbon dioxide dry ice and water ice, we have sand dunes, landslides, we even have atmospheric phenomena such as dust devils. And now we understand a bit more why Mars is so much more fascinating than the poor Moon. Hey, cheer up, Moon! You also have your advantages, about which we, by the way, talked last week in this episode here. But another big pro for Mars is...
9. Mars offers better protection from solar and cosmic radiation. While on the Moon, no atmosphere protects you from the bombardment of brutal solar and cosmic radiation. On Mars, you at least have a thin atmosphere. Now granted, it's really thin as compared to Earth, with only a maximum pressure of around 1.2 kilopascals in the lowest lying plains, or 1.2% of Earth's atmospheric pressure at sea level. But this is still infinitely better than no atmosphere at all, because even that thin atmosphere already offers some protection against cosmic rays. In fact, the annual radiation dosage on Mars is only 260 millisievert on average, compared to the Moon's 400 millisievert during a solar minimum. Now, during a solar maximum, in the lowest lying plains on Mars, we would actually go down as low as 100 millisievert per year. That's 4 times lower than the average radiation dosage on the Moon. Even more astonishingly, this is actually a bit lower than the average radiation dosage on the ISS, as shown in this chart here, link in the video description. Even more, if we'd build a base at the site of a mountain on Mars, the radiation dosage could be decreased even more, as the mountain would absorb a lot of the radiation coming from the site. Take that all together and combine it with a nice layer of 3D printed regolith dome with a thickness of 1 meter, and voila! You have a radiation on Mars only slightly higher than here on Earth at sea level. Now, taking every previous point in consideration, Mars would make a much better candidate for...
10. Terraforming. While terraforming the Moon would be pretty much impossible with any nearer future technology, so technology from the 21st or 22nd century, and terraforming Venus unfortunately also, terraforming Mars will likely be very possible with more advanced 21st and 22nd century technology. We said that Mars has a gravity 2.29 times as high as the Moon, so therefore Mars would cling more to its newly generated atmosphere. And having a terraformed planet, a new sister planet of Earth, is a goal really worth striving for. We will, by the way, do a complete Mars terraforming episode on Friday in 2 weeks to further analyze this absolutely fascinating possibility. So which scenario for Moon or Mars colonization would you prefer? Let us know what you think in the comments section.
And if you think that we have missed any good reasons why we should first colonize Mars, let us also know.
And in case you missed the top 10 reasons why it could make sense to colonize the Moon before Mars, you can watch the video right here.
So thanks for watching the JS Space Report, and I'd say, on to the future!